Hello friends, welcome to this video on triangles. In the previous video, we discussed the AAS congruence rule. Today, we will discuss the right angle hypotenuse side, RHS congruence rule. So let's start. To understand the RHS congruence rule, we will start with a pair of triangles. In the two triangles, two sides and one angle are equal. But these two triangles are not congruent. We can verify this by placing the two triangles one on top of the other. Can we draw two congruent triangles considering all the three given conditions? Where the two sides of the triangles are equal and one angle which is not within these two sides is also equal. You can verify that we can draw two such right angle triangles easily which satisfies all the three conditions. We can see that in these two triangles an angle which is a right angle is equal and one side and the hypotenuse are also equal. Are these two triangles congruent? Yes. These two triangles are congruent. This is a test for the congruence of triangles and we use this to verify the congruence of right angle triangles. We call this the RHS congruence rule. If in two right angle triangles, the hypotenuse and one side of one triangle is equal to the hypotenuse and one side of the other triangle, then these two triangles will be congruent. Therefore, this is called the RHS congruence rule. For the purpose of practice, we can draw some pairs of right-angle triangles. For example, draw two right-angle triangles where the hypotenuse is 10 cm and one side is 8 cm. So will the two triangles be congruent? Yes. Friends, a few pairs of triangles are displayed on the screen. Which of the following pairs of triangles are congruent according to the RHS congruence rule? In the first pair, both the triangles are similar as they have one equal side and equal hypotenuse. Therefore, they are congruent according to the RHS congruence rule. In the second pair, both the triangles are right angle triangle and one side is also equal, but their hypotenuse must also be equal, which is not the case here. Therefore, these two triangles are not congruent. Friends, that's it for today's session. Today, we learned the RHS congruence rule. In the next session, we will solve some questions based on the RHS congruence rule. Thank you.